The bacteria, bacterial nutrition. So different types of nutritional types, different types of nutritions are found in bacteria according to the getting of their energy and getting of their carbon. So from where the source they are getting, according to that they are divided into the different classes. So the nutrition also explained in the form of this classification. So bacteria shown as photoautotrophs, chemoautotrophs, photoheterotrophs, chemoheterotrophs. Photoautotrophs means here it is completely photosynthetic bacteria. Photosynthetic bacteria means it have the cell organelles, that is chromatophores. The chromatophores are present inside of the cell of bacteria. There the chromatophores can absorb the light. There the light is converted into the chemical energy. It means the source of energy is come from light. And the carbon source, for photosynthesis the carbon is compulsory. So the carbon source is from atmospheric CO2. So here it depends for only solar energy and carbon dioxide for their sources of energy and carbon. So photosynthesis is going on, that's why they are called as a autotrophs. In the presence of the light the photosynthesis is going on, so they are called as a photoautotrophs. Example are chromatium and chlorobium. Next type are chemoautotrophs. So here instead of the light, here chemical energy is released. So the chemical energy how it gain means oxidation of inorganic substances resulted to the releasing of energy. The released energy is obtained by the microorganism, that are bacteria. So the carbon source for it nutrition, that is from CO2. That's why they are called as a chemoautotrophs. So you are seeing the oxidation of inorganic substances. Different inorganic substances are oxidized by different types of the bacteria. According to that, again they are screened. So you see, you are seeing here the sulfur bacteria. Sulfur means sulfur oxidation resulted to the energy. So example is biggiota. Next, hydrogen bacteria. During nutrition, so hydrogen is oxidized here. So that is hydrogen, hydrogenomonas. So iron bacteria. So it involved in oxidation of iron. So the ferrous ions are turned into the ferric ions. Theobacillus ferrooxidans. So nitrifying bacteria is best example for chemoautotrophs. So nitrosomonas nitrobacter. The ammonia is converted, ammonia is oxidized into the nitrites by the presence of nitrosomonas. And nitrites are turned into the nitrates. So in the presence of nitrobacter, these two are nitrifying bacteria. So here finally it is a source for energy because of oxidation of inorganic substances or inorganic compounds. They are all under the group of chemoautotrophs, but they depends on to the energy sources, oxidation of inorganic substances, and the carbon sources from atmospheric CO2. Next type is photoheterotroph. In the presence of the light, they depends to organic substances. They depends on organic substances. Here the example are rhodospirillum, rhodopseudomonas. So these two are example of photoheterotrophs. And coming to the chemoheterotrophs. Chemoheterotrophs means they depends for energy as well as carbon source completely on organic compounds. Okay, so they are chemoautotrophs. They are again two types. They are saprophytes and parasites. Saprophytes are living organisms, free living organisms. They depends on to carbon source as well as energy source on the dead organisms, dead and decay material. Next, parasites. Parasite is completely dependent onto the living tissues of animals as well as plants. They are parasites. Okay, so the parasite, you take the bacteria, that is Delovibrio bacteriovorus. The bacteria leave an harmful bacteria. So this bacteria is using for the cleaning of Ganges water, purification of Ganges water. So the bacteria Delovibrio bacteriovorus, that is the best example of a bacterial parasite. Okay, so according to the nutrition, they are divided into the four: photoautotrophs, chemoautotrophs, photoheterotrophs and chemoheterotrophs.